Fishwest lures, and I've just cut 60 pound breaking strain with the, we'll just try something a bit different. This is the little popperator one here. I'll get a new one out of the box. What shall we choose? There we go. And that's just a little, looks like a fish. Billy Ho special. Make a loop. One, two, three. Slide it down. Pull it up. And I'll just take that little bit of a tag end off with it. With our knife. I'm not fully equipped here. All I've got is lures and some nylon. There's an old thing that if you get one, keep one kicking in the water, it'll attract the others. But I actually think this is a new species. We haven't caught this one before. And it is a queen fish, I think the Patsy called it. I'll just grab its tail. Have a good look at this guy. And as you can see, the mouth is sort of... and he's got little pads of teeth in there as well. But queen fish. There you go.
What a fabulous first day, and Captain's onto the biggest GT yet. He's been on that fish for about 20 minutes. I've got to say that the fish certainly took a shine to the Fishwest lures. Every time we've popped one out, wacko, something chased it or something connected. So it's been a fabulous day.
Good fish, Captain? Well, Captain Asparagus is absolutely delighted with that. A good 25 pound odd giant trevally. Well done, Captain. Well, that's enough fishing for today, and it's off back to Karratha. And I have a chat to the people at the Mercure Inn. Janica, could you tell us something of the specialties of this?
Australia is very popular, and I've always wanted to catch a GT. And casting poppers towards the rocks and winding them back fast as possible is the way to get them. The Fishwest lures are unique, and I'm really enjoying using them.
Yep, oh, look at that, that's a nice fish. You got him, have you? Look like a big trout.
Just opened up and grabbed the lure. Big mouth. Wahanui. Picking up on
I'm not sure. I don't think it was at first, but...
Not bad. Beautiful fish. Tag and release.
Oh, where'd you catch that, man?
There it goes. Well done, Mr. Hohepa.
We caught it on a Fishwest little chugger face. Peter reckons that these don't work all that well on GTs. Well, we just proved him wrong. There you go, look at that. Captain Asparagus biffed his lure in close and he's come up with what they think is a shark mackerel, which is something with teeth and goes very, very quick. The captain seems to have taken a bit to get him under control, but he's got him there. Oops, the gaff has come out. That looks like a serious fish. You've got to get the gaff out. And there it is, a shark mackerel. And the old captain's delighted. Another species to add to his collection of fish that he's caught over the years.
That's not a bad sharky.
Fish jumping all over the place here. Yeah. One of them's probably lying.
They're going around the boat everywhere. Not a bad fish you got there, I think.
Little fish in the water.
You've got a mackerel and you had another one following him. Yeah? Oh no, it's a tuna. It is a tuna.
Look at that, folks.
Look at that. Lovely.
Look at that. Beautiful. Western Australia. Bonito. Chicken of the sea. Shark mackerel.
Yep.
Trevor says that's a shark mackerel. Shark mackerel. You can see the little teeth around, but boy, did he go. Just for the size of it, he just went...
Yeah, these mackerel don't grow as big as the narrow broadband mackerel. So, yeah, he's a nice one.
Anyway.
Away he goes.
Shark mackerel. What next?
A couple of huge manta rays were swimming along the side of the coast, and Trevor says underneath the manta rays is a fish called a cobia, which is very much like the New Zealand kingfish in the body, but it certainly has a different head. The cobia use the manta ray as a hiding place, and when a fish swims by they think they can eat, they'll just fly out from underneath the manta ray and grab it.
Just cast the popper in a couple of manta rays. Humongous manta rays. And this cobia, which is a black kingfish, which I've yet to see. It's quite down there.
Very hard fighting fish. Also a very, very good eating fish.
Really?
Yes.
Well, we can eat this one?
Yes.
So, Johnny will be
happy, yeah?
Very happy.
Oh, yeah, if you want to feed a good fish, this is a good eating fish, cobia. I think it rates a 4-star fish, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He looks like you got about 10 kilo of cobia there. I'm surprised he's not giving you more than the grief than he's already given you. They look very similar to a shark. A lot of people confuse them with sharks. And we'll cut them off. You want, yeah, for sure, mate. He's well hooked. Right down his throat.
Got a head like a kingfish.
Yep. Yeah, he's still a bit lively. I thought he might have been a bit lively. That's a nice cobia, mate. He's done well there. Actually, the Australian record cobia, 38 kilos caught here. On 10 kilo line, yeah. But that's a nice fish, mate.
And that's a cobia. In relation to the kingfish, look at the tail, look at the fin. It's got a different head, really. Maybe a different colour. But for the size of it, she went like a red goat. Well done, sir.
No worries, mate.
And we're going to have this for tea.
I knew when we seen the manta rays, there's a good chance there'd be a cobia on it. Spotted the cobia through the popper.